husband, boyfriend, or grandfather? Is there a difference? Or is it just males don't stay in hospitals, we found out? Some are culturally, some are because they're not around. What's your take on it? But we were talking about this. You had said it. And I said it was sexist. So why do you think you said what you said that most people wouldn't have
done? Well, I said that most of the times we have grandfathers at the hospital. So, like with both you and Daniel here, they have to clarify who you are to the baby. Because without realizing Daniel's here, they automatically assume that you're the baby's dad.
Right.
That's what they would automatically assume, especially being that there's another black male in the room.
Right. I think the question is to me is, why don't men stay in hospitals? Men. Because black men may not be around, and that's a stigma, but it's a fact. It's a statistical fact, right? But why don't men stay in hospitals?
Well, we were talking about earlier, I think it has a lot to do with how the hospital is an emotional environment and men are not supposed to be emotional.
Or they
are not allowed to be emotional.
Or emotionally strong.
Right.
So, the question I probably have for men watching this, did you want to be in the room with your child being born, and if you don't have a child, could you see yourself in the room with the child being born?
Well, and then,
yeah.
As a grandfather, would you be in the room with your daughter having a baby?
Because
that's where we're really curious.
Yeah, we're
not necessarily curious if the father would be there, father of the baby,
right?
Because that is more normal than the grandfather being there. So, like, my dad is here for his grandchild. So, as a grandfather, would you be there for your daughter's labor?
And could you see the labor happen?
Right. Like, would you be in the room not right. the waiting room. Somewhere in the hospital, like, in the room.
And then, because we asked a question, we asked one of our nurses, and it was said, the phrase was, I don't have that
relationship
with my father. And what she meant by that relationship, she didn't say that her relationship isn't close with her dad.
I think it's more of a comfortableness.
Yeah. So, you daughters.
But you want to know what, though?
What?
I don't think Haley would be comfortable with you in the room with her.
The second oldest.
Yeah. Or Justice.
The third oldest. But we don't know. We could ask.
We could ask them, but knowing them, I don't see them being comfortable with you being there.
So it's not...
Not during all the, like...
This. Because the procedures are going on.
Yeah. And not that he's looking. He's behind the drapes or, per se, like, behind the knees, you know, but I don't care that he's in the room. Or my sister is in the room, you know, and...
But there's all kinds of sisters there sometimes in the room.
No, but I'm saying, like, it's not bothering me that there are other people in the room, whether it be male or female. Mm-hmm. I mean, honestly, if there's a stranger in my vagina,
like the doctors. Yeah, they're strangers.
They're strangers to me. I don't know them from the person on the street.
Is that a problem? I mean, we know when we talk about emotions and stuff like that in our civilization that I think this is not talked about. I'm not talking about the pregnancy. I'm not talking about being in a pregnancy room or your daughter's room or your wife's room. I'm talking about the closeness because it's not intimate. They say it's too intimate to be in a room, right? Isn't that what?
Well, the nurse called it. It's an intimate moment for her, or for like us being in labor.
Okay, so but what does it have to do with being a grandfather, being in the room, and being looked at as being intimate.
So not, I don't think she was thinking like
sexual,
you being intimate, but like it's an intimate moment
it is
for
intimate.
Me
it is.
That I'm inviting you into.
Right.
So for some people, it's might be too much of a personal intimate moment for them to share.
So that means other people. So does it go back to you were daughters may not be close with their fathers? And if people say, well, I'm close with my dad, but is this a different closeness? Is it, you say closeness, like I can tell my dad things, but I couldn't have him in my room? Then, so that you can almost question, is it, why don't you feel comfortable? I'm not saying the choice. You can have your choice, right? But why don't you feel comfortable?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know either. I think that's why
we're here. So I'm clearly not.
No, I'm not talking about you, but I'm talking about the question. So, because I think people need to ask themselves the question. Every time we do podcasts, ultimately, I want you to ask a question about, could I be in the room? That's a question. If you're a father, grandfather. And if you're a daughter, could I have my father in the room or my grandfather, you know, other than my husband, other than my spouse, or my intimate other, my sexual relationship partner other? Could I have